Hey everyone, it's Jan from The Last Stitch. In today's video I will talk about my next book project. In case you didn't know, I don't just make YouTube videos, I also write sewing books. My first book came out in 2017, it's called Sewing Activewear. And then in 2019 I published my second book, Master the Cover Stitch Machine. And the cool thing about this, even though I've been self-publishing and done pretty much everything myself, including both the photography and the design and sorting out the distribution and printing for the print version of the book, these books have actually done really well and been very well received, and I felt that there's definitely a need for that type of instructional sewing book still that has a lot of illustrated step-by-step techniques. We also will learn how to mimic, you know, more professional techniques. So with that in mind, and the fact that I really like making books, because that's something that I can put together so many of my creative interests in one product, and that's how bookmaking feels to me. So even though it's extremely time consuming and I'm absolutely drained after I finish each book project, I've actually started to work on book number 3. And that's what I'm going to talk about in today's video. And you might wonder, if you haven't already, if you follow me on my blog, thelaststitch.com, or over Instagram, laststitch, you probably already have seen this. But if you haven't, well, then I'm going to tell you, I am writing a book about sewing jeans. Yes, because I've actually been sewing my own jeans for, I think, about 20 years now. It's definitely one of those projects that I really enjoy, and I also really enjoy learning how we can mimic professional techniques using our own home sewing equipment. And I started being a bit more serious about it back in 2009, because then I did a blog post series where I dissected a pair of ready-to-wear jeans and looked on see how I could mimic that as closely as possible, because back then a lot of the jean sewing pattern had very, how shall I put it, non-standard techniques for sewing jeans. Instead, they were very similar to how you make a regular pair of trousers, which is completely different from how you sew jeans. So then that was blog series really well received, and now obviously a lot has happened since then, and a lot of indie pattern designers has put out really cool jeans patterns where contemporary jeans instructions. So, you know, sewing your own jeans has become a really popular thing, I've noticed, among the sewing community. But there is still not a dedicated published book about how to sew your own jeans, especially in a print version. So I felt that, why not me doing that? Because it's obviously something I'm really passionate about, and I have lots and lots of ideas about this book and what I want it to be about. So I just felt that this is definitely a book project that I want to delve into. And what will this book contain now? Well, I am definitely in the beginning stages of it, but I have a pretty set outline of what the book contains, but I'm definitely open for suggestions, because, well, this is so important that I get right, because I definitely want to make sure it's a book that really answers your questions and the things that you want to learn from a jean sewing book. I will of course talk about the different type of fabrics that you can use for when you're making your own jeans, you know, things like dyes, weight, weave, all that good stuff. I will also have a section about pattern alterations. So for instance, if you want to turn your jeans into a pair of skinny jeans, if you want to add bootcut, if you do want to do straight leg, if you want to do jeans that has an outer seam that is a selvage, so you need to have a straight seam on the outside, I will show how to adjust the inseam so you can make that happen. So there were a lot of different like adaptations on how to make your own pattern. Of course, I will not be able to draft the full jeans pattern because of the limitations of self-publishing, which is a story for another day. But if you have some type of pant patterns already, or a jeans pattern you want to adapt, you will find those tips really useful. And I will also have a set of different type of templates and pattern pieces for smaller things. For instance, for the front pockets, back pockets, templates when you're sewing button flies, and jean zipper. And those, if you get the print book, you will be able to download them digitally. And a good thing about those smaller pattern pieces is that most of them will fit into one piece of paper, at the most two, I think, which will definitely be a nice thing because you don't need a tape to get a lot of things, but they will definitely be really useful if you want to make a jeans pattern, you know, with more professional looking pieces. So I have a lot of ideas for what I want to add on that as well. And then of course there'll be a lot of step-by-step tutorials that will be very detailed, illustrated, photographed, just like in my previous book, because that method of teaching has been so well received. I've got so many comments that you really like that type of style of teaching. So while it's super, super time consuming, I definitely want to make that kind of book again. So you can definitely expect a lot of that. And I will go through all the different methods of assembling jeans. There will be variation depending on what type of jeans you're doing. And of course, how to add, you know, your different design details. So everything will be very clearly illustrated. So when will this book be out then? Well, the plan is in spring of 2020. I can't give you an exact month right now because, to be honest, I haven't really gotten started too much on the book. I have some things done already and I just settled on the design, which I think is going to be really, really nice. But if you want to get notified on the book, you can definitely check out the link in the description section where you can sign up to be notified on book updates and when it's out. So check that out as well. But the goal is definitely to be sometimes in the spring of next year. Fingers crossed for me, and I definitely need having you cheering me on because while I do love making books, I'm also a little bit overwhelmed at the moment because I knew how much work to get into. But there's also something so deeply satisfying of having a book out there and also getting all that wonderful feedback from you guys who have enjoyed the books that I've done previously. That's definitely something that keeps me motivated, even though I'm sometimes overwhelmed of doing such big projects as a bookmaking, a sewing book. And also I have another cool thing that I want to share with you, because as a part of the research of making this book, I actually met with a Swedish jeans making pro earlier this summer, and I learned so much. It was such a fantastic meeting. We definitely totally nerded out, and he went through, you know, explaining every little detail that goes into jeans making, and he also taught me a lot of fun things that I wasn't really aware of, and I want to share with you guys some of those cool things about jeans making as well if you're curious. And so here goes a little bit of a list of fun facts about jeans making. First of all, I had no idea, but in a factory setting, at least the factory he's working with, a pair of jeans takes 9 minutes to sew. 9 minutes! That's crazy! That's crazy! I mean, jeans making is quite a cumbersome process when for us home sewers. I mean, it can take days to finish a pair of jeans. But yeah, in the factory, of course, there are a lot of people involved and there's an assembly line process. But yeah, 9 minutes, that's crazy to think about. Obviously, a lot of people are interested in sewing with selvedge denim. And selvedge denim is where you have that decorative edge, which has usually a contrasting yarn that is red or sometimes blue. And those were traditionally woven on looms that are very narrow, so about 70 centimeters, which is less than a yard wide. And obviously, when you wanted to work with that type of selvedge denim, which is now mostly actually manufactured in Japan, because they have actually imported a lot of those looms from North America. But when you are sewing with those narrow fabric, it can be a bit hard to guesstimate how much fabric you will need. But he gave a rule of thumb and he said you need to have about 2.5 meters, which is, I think, roughly about 2.7 yards, if I'm not mistaken. He said that's a good rule of thumb if you want to make jeans using selvedge denim. Of course, it will depend if you're short or wide or whatever, but for the most part, that is his rough estimate. And for lining fabric, the standard lining fabric for jeans is a cotton poly mix, usually poplin fabric. But if you want to make this traditional, authentic, you know, Japanese denim or the sort of jeans aficionado denim, it's actually, you shouldn't use that type of lining fabric. Instead, if you're really hardcore about it, you should opt for a unbleached 100% cotton twill fabric. So that's basically what the jeans nerds say is like the true way of doing lining fabric. So that's a fun fact. I didn't know that, but definitely looks very nice. So if you want to make those authentic denim, you should definitely go for the 100% unbleached cotton twill instead. If you checked on some ready-to-wear jeans, you will actually see that the inseam can be a little bit uneven and twisted if you compare the right to the left. And you can actually control that, he says. So to get that twist, you start sewing from the right leg. And then when you're sewing jeans, you obviously sew it in one swoop like this. You start from one hem and then you sew all the way over the crotch and then down to the second hem. And he said for that sort of authentic twist, you should start sewing from the right and then go to the left. That's, I hadn't spotted that before, but he was very particular about those little details. Now, of course, when you're making jeans, you definitely want to get the right weight. And he said that, you know, the most traditional weight range is about 12 ounces up to 16. 16, it will start to get really stiff and uncomfortable. He says that in Japan, they go up, I think, to almost 20, but those jeans basically are so stiff that they can actually stand on their own if you put them up. So that is just for those really hardcore. So the normal is probably about 12 to 14 when it comes to regular denim for most of us. He also told me that denim brands are really particular about the recovery of fabrics, especially if they're doing stretched denim, because I've noticed some of the denim fabrics that are available to us home sewers has an issue that they don't really recover. So they start to sag a little bit, and that is not okay apparently in the denim industry. So they actually test fabrics. They have a very standardized process for this. So what they do is that they hang a pre-measured piece of fabric and then they attach a weight at the lower edge of that denim swatch, and that they let it hang for a set amount of hours, remove the weight, check how much it recover, and then it's just a tiny bit of range which is allowed. So if the denim piece doesn't recover within that range, then they won't make jeans using that fabric. So I thought that was really interesting. So, and perhaps that could be a tip. So if you're a little bit unsure, you can basically go to a fabric store, get a swatch, try to stretch it out using weights or some other way, and then test the recovery, and that will probably give you a good indication before you start making a pair of jeans that will start to sag. So I thought that was a really interesting fact, and it does make sense because that really can be a very annoying thing to happen. And he also told me that 100% cotton denim is making a strong comeback, especially among the younger consumer. So basically now the hippest thing is 100% cotton jeans inspired by classic like Levi's 501s. He said though that people in my generation still are very fond of stretch jeans, but he's noticing a big shift when it comes to young consumers. So that's really interesting to know, because lycra in or spandex in denim has been such a massive thing now for decades. So that's really interesting to hear now that the younger generation is starting to reject those stretch fabrics and actually opting for the 100% cotton fabrics. I thought that was really interesting, and I was definitely curious now, and I will make a pair of jeans, I think, now upcoming for the book, actually using 100% cotton. So I'm really interested about seeing how that works as well. So these were some fun facts about denim making. Now, keep your fingers crossed and please cheer me on, because I have so much to do with this book project and need all the encouragement I can get, because to be honest, I feel a little bit overwhelmed just talking about it. But I know I will make this book happen, as I've done with my previous book, so I do feel confident, but also a little bit nervous. Anyways, as I said, you can sign up for updates, check the description box, and stay safe.